This is Casey Kasem on American Top 40 in Hollywood. You know, one of the most common products in the world is paper. You can't turn around without seeing or touching paper or a paper product. But it wasn't always that way for a certain rock and roll pioneer. For lack of paper, he once wrote a song on a gunny sack, a burlap bag. And this is his story. He grew up in a very poor family in Jackson, Tennessee. He says his family was so poor they could barely afford the essentials like food and coal, never mind the luxury like paper to write on. So as this young man grew up, simple things like clothing became very important to him, especially shoes. Almost as important as his music. You see, he wrote songs and sang and played the guitar. In 1955, he heard that a record company owned by Sam Phillips was looking for new artists for his label, Sun Records. So the young man headed for Memphis with that song he had written originally on a gunny sack with a piece of chalk. He auditioned for Sam Phillips, and Sam signed him to record his song. A song that in 1956 became a number two smash. It also became a hit for Elvis Presley, Boyd Bennett, and years later, Johnny Rivers. The young man who wrote and first recorded it was Carl Perkins. Here he is with that song that began his career, an AT40 extra, Blue Suede Shoes, Carl Perkins.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go.
A number two smash from 1956, Blue Suede Shoes by the man who wrote it, Carl Perkins, an American Top 40 extra, as the countdown rolls on.
For Casey Kasem, I'm Mark Elliott. Back in 1956, Carl Perkins, one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, survived a terrible car crash that killed his brother. Well, Carl's a survivor for a second time. He just beat cancer. Details coming up.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Mark Elliott in for Casey Kasem. Casey's Top 40 originates in Hollywood. Now, you may not be familiar with the name Carl Perkins, but for those who followed the history of rock and roll, Carl is as famous as Elvis Presley, Jerry Lee Lewis, and Johnny Cash. He's one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, one of the legendary singers who recorded for Sun Records back in the mid-50s. And it was back then, in 1956, that Carl recorded his most famous rock song, a classic that sounded like this.
You can do anything, half of my blue suede shoes.
From 1956, that's Carl Perkins with his song Blue Suede Shoes. In the years since, like his friend Johnny Cash, Carl has had a lot of success on the country charts. And he's also had a lot of sorrow and tragedy in his life. Back in 1956, when Carl was beginning to hit big, he was in a terrible car crash. Carl emerged with broken bones, scratches, and bruises. Tragically, his brother was killed. And more recently, Carl thought he'd come to the end of his rope himself. He was having trouble swallowing, and so he went to see a doctor who told Carl the painful spot in his throat was a cancer. Carl says, quote, I've stared into the face of death and spit in its eye many times in my life, but when my doctor told me what I had, my blood ran cold with fear. Carl was told he could risk throat surgery and possibly lose his voice, or he could try the less sure cure of radiation therapy. It wouldn't hurt his voice, but it might not stop the cancer. For Carl Perkins, there was no choice. He couldn't risk losing his voice. And so, for 12 weeks, he endured the pain of radiation. His weight dropped 35 pounds. His neck was covered with blisters. He shivered constantly, even when it was hot out. But in the end, at the beginning of September, Carl Perkins was cancer-free. He says, quote, I'm the luckiest man in the world. And that's our update on the man who gave the world blue suede shoes at the beginning of the rock era, Carl Perkins, as the countdown rolls on.
Casey's Top 40.